guys, welcome back to channel 48 and ladies, of course. You're looking at the Asus Nexus 7 and I installed Android 8 onto it. Yes, Android 8 for this device. It's in the making, peeps. Really amazing work, and I'm kind of happy to see this and to bring this to you. Okay, and here you can see it, Android 8 1.0. Okay, this is the Nexus 7. Somewhere there should say Nexus 7. See that? So this is kind of cool. This is a development that is going on the background that in fact is so so anonymous, in fact, because I think this is created by, yeah, when these guys post to this Russian site, what is it called again? See what it is called, something like Yandex or so. Yeah, and they have no site at XDA yet because he didn't want to create a new thread, but he's building AOSP 8.1 for tilapia, in fact. And here I'm gonna show you the article in the forum that I found, and these are all guys that in fact are asking for Android 8. And a junior member by Neo Chapai, here is his name, Neo Chapai, you cannot read it too good, eh? Nevertheless, he is working on a ROM for this device. So is it any good? Well, it's in very early stage. It does not have a boot animation. It comes with very little applications, as we know, from AOSP. But for now, what I can say, it's when it falls asleep, then it will stock up the whole thing. And the only thing that you can do is hold down the volume and the power for 10 seconds, and then the device should go off. All these applications that you see, I installed manual, and even my car launcher is working really nice, as you can see. You see, I as well set it up, and all these applications in fact were not pushed to the device because that is not possible at this time yet. This is the desktop that you can use. Sometimes it rotates and sometimes it just don't, it does not. And here you can see it. It's a nice ROM that you can go ahead and test. I will put the link for you guys so you can test it out. Okay, but in fact it's not about this ROM. You know, even though the title is saying Android 8 ROM and the best ROM for, you know, this device, it's not about this ROM. This was just to, you know, kind of tell you about the development that is going on. Probably this will be the first video on YouTube. I don't think that there's an Android 8 showing here on this platform that is N for tilapia and for the grouper. This is a unified ROM. Probably he didn't realize that he created a unified ROM, because he said that it was only for the tilapia, but I flashed it to my grouper and everything went fine, you know, because these devices, they have differences, but everything works. Wi-Fi works, sound works, you know, you can listen to the radio, you can play with it, but don't let it fall asleep, because then then you will have to wake it up the hard way. Lovely sound, and it as well records sound. I also have my recorder in here. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's your boy channel 48 out of Groningen town, moving all around. Yeah. Let me see what this is.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's your boy channel 48 out of Groningen town, moving all around. Yeah.
Craziness. I injected the browser as well, just to see if that all works. And hold on. Allow, deny. Okay. Don't ask me for these crazy things, because I don't like. Next. There you go. Turn rotate, please. Cancel. Rotate. Ah, to now. Rotate now eventjes dan. Nou, oké. Okay. So, yeah. It's not rotating, but hey. Internet is working. So, I'm very happy with this build. So, Neo Chapai, good luck with developing, yeah, the Android 8 and maybe soon even Android 9. You never know with these guys, peeps. So, yeah, but now I'm gonna show you the very best ROM. And I'm also gonna show you how to put this thing into a recovery mode, because that is as well a little bit different than the tablets that I showed yesterday, the Samsung tablets. What you will do is hold down the volume, okay, and then press power and keep holding these two until you see the screen. Then you let go of both. And then with the volume down or up, you can choose whatever you where you want to go into. You can power off, you can start the operating system, you can restart the bootloader, okay, and you can go into a recovery mode. This is exactly what we're gonna do, and we're gonna hit the power to confirm, and this will bring us in a recovery mode. This should be, I think, version 2.8, and I have a video how to, you know, from original push the via ADB the twerp to the device. I have a video showing that, including all the commands. Find it in my list. It's the first video that I created about this device some years ago when I bought it, but the video is still there, so it still can help you to, you know. So we're gonna do advanced wipe, data catch system, and Dalvik. And we go back, and then we're gonna go home, and we're gonna say install from the SD card. And then I will have to go for the latest grouper effect, AOSP ROM that was created for this device, and that is this ROM. So we're gonna flash it. And this was by Andisa. Andisa is the developer of this ROM. Don't forget, whenever you're gonna put the charger inside, it's always different, the opposite way from a Samsung. Don't push it in the other way, otherwise you will mess up the slot, and then sometimes even lose it, and you won't be able to charge the device anymore. So be very careful with this slot. Never push it in too hard, okay? This thing was made to die, because if you're using Samsung, then you might be, you know, putting it the wrong way inside. Then you cannot charge the device anymore, and then you cannot flash ROMs anymore. So now we just flash the ROM. We're gonna go one back, and I'm gonna try to flash my ham police mod. I think it did not flash it. We go one back, and then we're gonna reboot back into a recovery, and we hit don't install. I never updated the twerp yet. Install. And the reason for that is because I can't install images from here, and I'm too lazy to go via ADB. There we go. Now it's installing. So you first install the ROM, and then you reboot in twerp back to recovery, and then you install the mod. Could be that the boot animation will not fit and probably might not even show in the boot up. Don't worry about that, I will fix that in your build. It will work, okay, but it could work, I'm not sure. Maybe it will work. It's always a surprise. And I saw something there. There it goes. It's booting up the wrong way. Okay. It's acceptable. It should be horizontal. So, in fact, I messed up. Yeah, these things happen, huh? These things happen. But it also looks nice like this. This looks... I know operating systems that used to present their boot up like this. Windows, for instance. Way back in 1998. So, this still looks good. It's not that bad, okay? It's not perfect. It had to be, you know, the other way. But okay, it's forgivable. I'm gonna leave it just like this. I think it looks lovely. I love the black on top and at the bottom. And it also gives you the feeling that this is a device that should be used in a vertical way. Portrait. But in the desktop, of course, I think you'll be using it mostly in horizontal mode, just because that's way easier to do many things. It's a nice little tablet. It will fit very nice in your car. And thanks to it as well having the car launcher, you will, yeah, it will just be a pleasure to use this device again. Okay, you could connect it to your, how you say that, to your amplifier in your car. If your car has a line in output or input, then you can use the output of this tablet. That's the speaker out, the headphone jack. From there you bring it into your line in of your radio, and then you will be surprised how good your sound will be. Of course, you could as well link your phone via Bluetooth to the device, so you can make, I think, conversations hands-free. So all these things you can do with this device. It's such a waste not to use it anymore. And if you can find one on marketplace cheap, buy it. Okay, I have a complete procedure how to bring this thing to what it is now, from the stock to here. And I'm not the only one. There are more people here on YouTube showing that. And it's a Nexus 7. And you know about Nexus devices. They are always getting, you know, a piece of the pie. I still have my Nexus 1. That is, I think... what is that again? The Samsung S1. The thing is running Android 7.1 too. It came out in the time of the iPhone 3GS. Just think of it. Nobody wants to have a 3GS anymore. But the Samsung S1 is still doing its job. It's still, you know, it's still there. It's amazing. It's formidable. You're looking at the real-time boot, just showing it so you know how long it will take. This video won't become such a long video. Most of the times my videos are, yeah, very how you say that, educational, so they take a little bit more time to grab yourself a nice cup of coffee. Always enjoy a nice cup of coffee whenever you do these kinds of things. It's very relaxing. And then you won't get statical and nervous, and your hands won't start sweating. It's all about being chill and relaxed. And that's how you can learn a whole lot about these kinds of devices. Many people on marketplaces are selling them very cheap. $10, $15. You find the Asus Nexus. So now, you can choose out of... Oh, this is a little bit over-lightened. But here you can see it. You can choose out of the normal launcher, the car launcher, and the Nova launcher. I would go for the Nova launcher, because I also added some very nice goodies in here. And the Nova launcher knows exactly how to deal with them. For instance, the amazing icon pack. that we have in here. So let's immediately do that. We go to look and feels. Where are you, look and feel? Oh, there. We go to look and feels, and then we say icon theme, and then you go for the Mac Cat Pack. That's my latest, newest. It's amazing. It's beautiful. Round icons. I don't know what this is. I'm gonna remove. This is maps for your car thing. Here is your car launcher. So what you in fact gonna do is you're gonna have the car launcher here in the middle. Wait a minute, hold on. You're gonna remove this one here, remove, and then you're gonna put the car launcher in the middle. Okay, and this thing has no phone, so now we cannot swipe up, so you will have to go into the settings and go to the app widget and drawers and select to slide up, swipe open. Okay, and then up here you can as well immediately do the background. I would set the transparency first to 45% and then to black. That is very, very nice. Okay, then you can go to the dock if you wish, and then you can add the dock background. That is in fact the dock. You can choose out of platform, rectangle, rounded and arc. You see that these are all nice things, but I would go for rounded. Okay, it's just because we can. Okay, and I would set it to white. Then you will get the glass effect, you know, like this. Set it to 77%, no, not 77, 80%. That is nice. And then you can set the search bar in the dock. That looks kind of cool. I would set it below the dock. Okay, then you get a nice thick dock, you know. Let me see, what do we have more? We can set it to night mode in here, then it doesn't hurt your eyes. Always boom, black, you see that, boom. And now we're gonna go back home, and this is what we now have. You see that, a lovely dock. We can remove all these icons, so you get one page here. Okay, this thing we're gonna remove. We already have it at the bottom, remove. And this thing here, by pressing it you can as well edit it, the search bar. And then I would go for the Google one here, and then I would set the color. I would set the transparency as well to 82% or so. Hey, I said transparency, hello, to 82%, and then white. Let me see what we got. Oh, you see that? That's very nice, huh? This is just the Google thing, you know. And here we're gonna remove. We don't want to make this thing ugly, so we're gonna give it some nice widgets. We give it this round clock. This round clock looks amazing, you know, in the system. It looks beautiful. As my friend Hater says, GTA, the GTA man, he said, yeah, look and feels is key. And that is really true. And you know, that's why I always try to make the devices, the thing, the ROMs and the distros that I mod, I try to make them as beautiful as possible. We have the tools. We don't have to reinvent these tools. They are all there. We have guys creating these beautiful launchers and icon packs. Only thing that we must do, we, the creators, and I'm not talking about the developers, but the creators of these kinds of look and feels, only thing that we must do is get their works and put them in a nice place together, you know, so these guys can download their own ROM, because it's as well their work. I mean, if Ahmed comes and Ahmed sees this mod, he will want it, because his work is represented in here. You see, this was created by Ahmed, and he made it very nice. I love it very much. Look at how beautiful it is. This thing is beautiful. You know, we click to continue. We allow the location here so that it will give you, you know, right everything. You set the speed, maximum speed here in the Netherlands is 70, and you go put your applications. I have the TX radio. I have the police scanner radio. Where is it? Here, radio droid scanner radio. Radio droid is as well a very good application. It's tuned in radio, but then open source, you know. We have an app store powered by E. We have maps. Not sure if the maps are working, but you will tell me about that. Okay, and this is the same mod again that we're gonna flash to our device, the same mod that we used in the previous video about the 51, the 5100 and the 5110. And we even have Hampshire Radio, although I don't have an account for that, but I just put it in for the radio amateurs, you know, these guys, they like that. Yeah, so what can I put more there? Maybe a calculator, that's kind of handy. So I just fixed my desktop, as you can see. Now I want a nice little wallpaper. So this is a morning background will be, let's go for this one. And the night background will be, let's go for this one. Let me go home, boom. If we go into the, I think this is too much. This is too much. This is really too much. This thing should not have too much colors. I think this is the very best. So that's why this is a chameleon system. So now you are in the car system, but when you press the home, you are back in the normal system that you can use in any way. We even have some nice wallpapers. I'm gonna give it this orange one. It makes me always very happy, and I think it looks beautiful. You see that? And there we are, guys. And with one click, we are transformed to a car PC. And with another tap, we are back into the normal look and feels of the tablet, of the tablets that we know. So yeah, you have a two-in-one device thanks to the usage, the smart way of using the applications in this ROM. Okay. However, you see that this all looks nice and it's all beautiful, etc. All the credits for this goes to Endisa. Okay. So let that be clear. For this ROM, this ROM was by Endisa, and it was modded and made nice by me. Okay. So that is how the story is. So I say back to the studio.
Where am I? I have totally no complaints about this, what I'm showing you, and I'm sure you're gonna have a great time with your Asus Nexus 7 again. Well, I'm sure you already had a nice time with it, because it's just a beautiful device. Don't let it fall. Try to protect it. Find some cover where you can put it in. You know, treat the thing nice. It's a nice device. And there's development going on. By the way, this ROM, It's official AOSP. The Android 8 that I showed you in the beginning, that one is unofficial, but this is fully official. And we're getting updates very soon again. So I think in 1 month from now or so, Endisa will release the updated version for this device. So keep using it, don't let development die on this device. You know, keep using it. If you can support Endisa, support him. And then I want to say thank you for watching. If this video was cool, leave it a thumbs up. Of course, subscribe to my channel if you did not already, and don't forget to hit notifications, set them to on, so you'll be uploaded whenever I upload a new video again. See you then.